Bull of Heaven. Initially composed of Neil Keener and Clayton Counts, these two got together and wrote some eternal jams meant to run until the sun explodes. I mean that literally, but we'll get to that. See, Bull of Heaven are best known for creating tracks with insanely long run times. Like seriously, you thought you were special for listening to all of Freebird, all of Roundabout, all of f***ing American Pie? No. These dudes are straight up about it. You had to be dedicated to be a Bull of Heaven fan. People came out changed after Bull of Heaven, mostly by Etch. Why is that? Because they regularly put up single tracks that would ask for hours of your time, sometimes even significant portions of your lifespan. If you wanted to start off PP Baby Lil Weenie Simple, you could pull up Project 5, A Lovely Pair, which is only 12 minutes long. But man, what a 12 minutes it was. If you were a casual fan of the group, you might even sit through all of their debut hit single, Project 1, Weed Problem 1, which would only ask for 45 minutes of your time. Just put it on at the gym. If you were even a semi-dedicated listener, you might put on Project 28, Even to the Edge of Doom. A quick and easy 24 hours of your fleeting and irreplaceable life. And if you were the average Bull of Heaven, you'd have no problem skanking out to something like Project 208. As you etch on the inner window of your eye. A hot little jambo that'll run you 916 hours and 35 minutes per listen. Yeah, a little over 38 days of listening. And no breaks! I see you, fucker, going for that pause button. It's like you don't even appreciate art. But that's how your boys did things. And don't think you get to pretend you're Mr. Big Penis or Miss Big Anus just because you sat through one of their little beginner songs for babies. Because you haven't even listened through Project 209. Better known as Blurred with Tears and Suffering Beyond Hope. Oh my god, he just like me for real. I can tell you haven't listened to this one. Why? Because you haven't aged 6.4 months. I sat here. I counted. I've really got nothing better to do. And if you have listened through, that just means you get to tackle their next challenge. Bull of Heaven's Like a Wall in Which an Insect Lives and Gnaws. How long will this journey take? Well, I hope you've got some free time coming up in your schedule there, cowboy, because this one track is 50,000 hours long exactly. That is 5.7 years. More than half a decade for one song, Habibi. Do you even remember the kind of person you were 5.7 years ago? Seriously, think of what you were up to in, what is it, January 2018? Seems like a lifetime ago now, doesn't it? That was only one song's worth of time, apparently. I'm not letting the days go by. It's only been one song since 2018. I'm not wasting my life. But you pulled your sleeves up and your pants down, and by God, you endured it. Now you're a real aficionado of the arts, aren't you? No. Because before we let you into the club, you have to solve a little, math problem for us. See, between projects 238 and 260, you had tracks that would only sync up if you started playing them at the exact right time, depending on a specific mathematical algorithm. I really don't know how to do that. I've established I'm a brainlet. So sorry for all you STEM majors or whatever watching right now, though. You would start playing each of these 23 tracks one by one at the right time, and if you did it right, them synchronizing would only take, ah, fuck me, here we go, 8 septillion, 462 sextillion, 937 quintillion, 602 quadrillion, 125 trillion, 701 billion, 219 million, 674,955 years. 8 septillion years! Gives a whole new meaning to the phrase, I'll never hear the end of this, doesn't it? Enough time for your favorite galaxy, and every galaxy that galaxy has ever known, to implode! Before you even get to the good part of the song. Honestly, by the time Project 247 ends, you will be dead. I don't mean to sound cynical. I'm just being straight clinical. So, you know, maybe just put this one on in the background while you get some other things done. There's also a few select tracks Bull of Heaven's released that were MP3 files embedded within RAR archives, or locked away behind password-encrypted files. so he had to go out and solve a whole damn ARG just to get to listen to him. Completely out there listening if you compare with anything else in your Spotify playlist. But you want to know what Bull of Heaven's longest playing track is that doesn't involve all this fucktarded math and nerd shit, right? Sure, dude. Just put on... Ah, fuck, man. Lord, give me strength. Project 310, Omega Sigma Rho X0, distributed amongst 2 to the 18th power times 5 to the 18th power. Okay, and then all of that multiplied by P times K times K times K. Even the song names take up too much of my goddamn time. I just hope you've got 3.343 quintillion years to spare. That's this many. I can't even comment on just how long that is because, frankly, I can't come up with something in the universe that there's 3 quintillion of. You know, besides hot fucking updates on this video. Yeah, go ahead and murk that like button for me, pimp. See, you can't even download their discography on some kooky pirate site unless you're drowning in storage. Because I'm pretty sure that track I just mentioned probably takes up more data than the Zuck can snort through a straw when he's done sunbathing on a hot rock somewhere. For one music track! I don't care how stoned you are, no avant-garde experimental anti-music is worth that much space on my hard drive. My precious hard drive, where I keep all my PS2 ISOs and my pictures of massive, sweaty ass. There's a reason you listen to simulations of Bull of Heaven tracks on YouTube instead of actual full-length albums, or hell, even just individual tracks. You just can't upload some of these songs in their entirety. Neil and Clay knew what they were doing, man. Metallica wishes they could filter music pirates the way these two nice boys did. You gotta go straight to their website to have any hope of realizing their vision. That is, if it's not currently crashed or something, as it's wont to do. The website gets a bit memey from time to time because of hosting, you know, eons worth of data. And even when you download everything legit, you still need like 5 squillion gigabytes of hard drive space to keep it all. But, how is the music? You know, musically. Oh well, I'm glad you asked. See, I lured you in with promises of showing you some fucktastically long run times, but now that I've got you here, I'm gonna spread some love to the lesser known tracks. The ones that aren't centuries long and mathematically brain melting. They're just brain melting and how absolutely flames they are. See, these Bull of Heaven fellers ain't just a gimmick. They don't just copy paste loops times a million and call that a release. They're musicians. Proficient, skilled, creative musicians who've released songs that are outstanding for reasons besides just their track length. Their discography spans genres and does them all well, from cold, repeating, industrial loops like this. To absolutely killer shit like this. From introspective and sobering ambient pieces. To some shit like this.
God. Baby God. He's a God. I love it. Bow to him.
Drone, ambient, post-rock, psychedelic, minimalist, stoner, doom. They've got all these styles locked the fuck down. So shout out to Neil Keener and Clayton Counts. Cause some of these songs are long, but they never go wrong. Tell you what, put on your fanciest headphones and I'll let you sit through my unorganized Bull of Heaven playlist on shuffle. We'll be right back. That's it. Smell you later, butters. Mwah.